The boys are on their way to see Wayne Rydell, who has an unusual collection of cars for an unusual business.
Basically, we supply a vehicle for the film and TV industry, which we've done for 35 plus years now. We supply vehicles to whatever the actual period is being shot in. Most people think that they need to be immaculate, and it's far from it. So we spend more time dressing a vehicle down and dirtying it up than we do polishing it and cleaning it.
Is this our man?
Yeah.
Wait.
Hello, mate.
Hello.
How are you? You're right.
Yeah, nice,
nice
to meet you. Cool.
How are you?
Yeah, good, thank you.
Look at this. This is all the cars that everybody's forgotten about in one place.
Yeah, there's quite a few of those around.
I have come to Car Hell Nirvana Disaster Area. I can't quite put my finger on what on earth is going on here. Some of these things are, God, they're stinkers.
But Renault 19 Shimano, I mean, that is a really unusual car.
What is it? I think that's cool.
Oh, you're so wrong.
Oh, you're so wrong.
How many cars have you got?
Now we're probably down to probably 150.
What?
Oh, we did have
down
over,
to.
We did have over 250.
It's very niche and it's very clever. You know what he's doing, buying dreadful cars that you wouldn't have thought anything about, but now they do put you in a place in time and history. This is really great fun. I see lots of terrible cars. Where's the Golf at?
That's tucked away in another little compound over here.
Can we go and have a look at that?
Yeah, certainly. Yeah, cool. Follow me and we'll go and find it. There it is.
That's nice.
Cars have to stir an emotion in you. I walked around the corner, I saw that Golf, and I'm like, yes, lovely. This is a nice car. If I'm buying a chair, it's about proportion. Everything's all about proportion. The Golf Mark 1, that's got proportion and style just dead right. The sort of slightly chunkier sort of rear pillar coming down and the way it angles back in for the fuel filler to go in there. The front just slightly tapering down to that sort of slim mouth across there. It's a beautiful design.
The Mark 1 Volkswagen Golf was designed by Italian Giorgetto Gigaro as the replacement for the Beetle. It went on sale in 1974, but it was the launch of the GTI in 1976 that changed the automotive landscape.
The Golf GTI really is kind of the granddaddy of all the hot hatches. And kind of like the Americans do muscle cars, which is blue-collar performance, the European take on that was the hot hatch. That's a car in an average three-door body shell with a peppy little engine, practicality, so four or five seats, a boot you can put your shopping into, but a car that you can razz down a B-road and have fun with.
This GTI was built in 1982, and Paul knows to look out for one particular problem.
They always rush around here, and then they always, always go on the boot. If you pull the boot seal away,
yeah, I guess
because the water always sits there.
It's pretty good for the ear again, though, isn't it?
Unbelievable. Look at the inner wings as well, look. It's mint.
But as far as Drew's concerned, there are one or two aesthetic problems that really need addressing.
There's a lot on the back of the car I really don't like. I didn't want to see any modifications on it. The wheels are horrid. And then the crime of all crimes in my book,
yeah,
the stupid drainpipe exhaust hanging off the back of it. The seats need redoing, don't they?
That is the right material.
I know it's the right material, but it's so faded. Got to be replaced. Can you get that cloth in the middle?
No, not really. You say that, it's not that much more vivid when it was new, though. When you see the original fabric recreated, it's a little bit brighter, but not a lot. The problem with wanting to change the fabric in that Golf is that VW just don't make it anymore. So I've got to find the person that does. I've got to find a trimmer, got to order it all up, book it in, pay for it. If you retrim that car, you're well into four figures. And will it add that to the value on the end? So my gut feeling is keep the trim in.
If this was an old armchair with lovely faded colour upholstery all over it, we'd leave it alone. But this isn't. This is a car and everything that we're doing to it is to make it look factory original.
A complete retrim could significantly eat into their profit margin.
How much is it, though?
I don't know, but it's not the cheapest. Then, obviously, the labour to stitch it all in.
This car warrants it.
The seats aren't the only bone of contention.
Early Mark 1 Golf GTIs didn't have four headlamps. It was just the two. I've got mixed feelings about it on this car, but I'm just thinking purity again, purity of design. Can we buy, Paul, a grille without the spots in?
When people buy a GTI, they kind of expect the twin headlamps. Even if the car wouldn't have had them as standard, most people had that option because it's kind of what you think of a GTI, isn't it?
You just want it back to original.
I want it totally original.
Yeah.
Totally original.
Yeah,
but what you don't know is it could have left the dealership like that.
It could have done.
Yeah.
Can we buy one anyway and just see what it looks like?
It won't look as good as that.
can we? Please, pity please.
Want to take it for a spin?
No, no.
Just make sure you bring it back in the same condition you take it away.
Having seen him drive, I can't...
No, I've got a racing driver's licence.
Yeah, and that's what worries me.
Oh, this is just great fun.
Isn't it cool?
Oh, yeah. Driving impressions, great. Really needs service. The exhaust's a nightmare.
Yeah, it's quite loud, isn't it?
Too loud.
Yeah. So what's your overall vision, no great one, for this?
So you open the door.
Yeah.
It's absolutely bone stock. You open the bonnet, it's absolutely stock. You open the boot, it's absolutely stock.
It's got the basis of a good car, hasn't it? So I think you're going to spend £3,000 just tidying it up, making it nice, making it really pretty on top of whatever we buy the car for. I think it could sell for as much as 12 and a bit, if we make it really nice. But that means we've got to buy it somewhere about 6, 7, really.
Yes. Brilliant, though, isn't it?
I love it.
Thank the Lord for the Mark 1 Golf GTI.
How do we get on, then?
Mega.
Good.
A few jobs,
but... It's as much fun as I remember.
Good.
So you're selling it on behalf of someone?
Yeah, I'm just getting it, you know, rid of it for the chap that owns it. So
what is the owner asking for it?
Oh, we're getting to the nitty-gritty. He really wants 6,000 for it. Unfortunately, yeah, I can't really haggle on it.
No, you
happy
need
with
to.
That? Cool.
I think that's fair.
Pleasure.
As always. Yeah.
Done.
Thank you.
We'll have it.
Cheers, guys.
Great car. Steal at £6,000, I think.
I just hope it's, you know, what you wanted, so.
Perfect.
We're big boys.
Sorted.
Particularly, and we know what we're doing.
Cool.
We know
I know what I'm doing.
You know what you're doing.
Yeah. So the job is now back to the workshop, get that interior done, get the wheel sorted, new grill, whichever way that goes, and then job done.